Hi guys, and welcome to a brand new video. Thank you so much for watching. Today's video is going to be a little bit different. We're gonna do a two-part makeup video inspired by the changes around the world and in technology. Because lately I've been thinking about how much everything has changed from the past, reminiscing about childhood. So it inspired me to create a video idea of doing something of those 2020 makeup looks that you see on Instagram models that's really popular right now in the beauty community. And I'm gonna do part of a 1920s like old school black and white film makeup. Since these makeup trends are so different, it's so crazy to see how much makeup has changed throughout the years through a 100-year span. So let's get started with that makeup. We're gonna do something a little creative and swipe away with a paintbrush to uncover the 1920s past from today's 2020 makeup look. Hopefully it'll turn out really cool, and today's video is partnered with LG Mobile. They sent over the new dual screen phone for me to play with and to use for some makeup looks and test out the new features, so I'm excited to show you all the cool things that we could do with this baby. So when I'm preparing my makeup transformation videos, I like to lay out all of the makeup that I'm going to possibly use just so that I could get organized and make sure I have everything at the ready in front of me. Make lists on my phone. Like on the LG dual screen, this also records in 8K, has a 64 megapixel lens with super clear and very detailed video and pictures. And let's get started with the makeup. So to start off talking about everything that has changed over the years, oh my gosh, I remember growing up after elementary school, when we went to middle school, or is it junior high school? Whichever you call it in your area, we had my absolute favorite thing that I use till this day, which is agendas. Whether it was agenda or you had one of those old school composition books, whatever the schools told you to use because you had so many classes other than staying in just one class, you had so many subjects. It taught us really how to break down our day, stay organized. I think that's why they showed us agendas and just task lists like that. We also had Trapper Keepers. I had a Lisa Frank Trapper Keeper in elementary and middle school. I also had a Pokemon Trapper Keeper that held all of my Pokemon collection cards. And instead of Trapper Keepers and agendas, I still handwrite agendas, but what I use most, even more than agendas, is on my new LG dual screen phone. What I use is my Google Calendar. This tells me when I'm uploading videos, when I have appointments for the dentist, when I have meetings and stuff like that, those Zoom meetings. Breaks it all down. I list everything I can in this. It's so great and so efficient, and it's like the modern day. I pretend like this is my old school Trapper Keeper. Which I love this phone because you could use it with or without the case. So you can use it as a regular phone, or if you want to put the case on, you can use the dual screen. So I could be looking at my calendar while going through Instagram at the same time. It is my favorite. And I can't forget when I'm doing notes about my videos on the dual screen phone, I can use like the regular little keypad that most phones have, or I can use up the whole entire screen. So it's like a computer, desktop, laptop, keyboard in my actual phone. And I don't know why this excites me so much, but staying organized is so important in my life. Even when I was younger, I was so obsessed with staying organized. I organized all my dolls. And not only that, but I organized my little, I had a little safe and notes, like journal notes, because I was obsessed with the movie Harriet the Spy. I absolutely wanted the electronic password journal. I don't know what it was, maybe it was the commercials, but back then those were everything. And I feel like now everyone has phones for notes. You can even talk to your phone and it will type for you. It's just such a weird modern take on everything that's been changing so much. Like, think about it. Remember when DVD players, when they first came out, this is gonna show my age, but they were $350. Now, they're like $35 or even less than that. It's insane how much things have changed over the years. Like, not too long ago, we were obsessed with Beanie Babies, Tamagotchis, and Silly Bands. And I feel like silly bands, today's silly bands is definitely slime. Slime is the new silly bands. And do y'all remember drive-in movie theaters? Like they had movie theaters back in the day, but they also had drive-in movie theaters, which were such an amazing thing. I cannot tell you the joy I had driving into a movie theater with my family. You could get all of the snacks for such a low, low price. And I swear it was as low as $7 to $10 for a car full of people. And they had special sub nights where kids were free or they ate free snacks. And you would park your car, get this old like electronic device box and put it in your car window where it hung there, and it looked like it was so big and bulky, it looked like it could literally break your car window, but it was just staying on, I think on a hope and a prayer. But in the middle of the parking lot, they had this snack station, little rickety shack of food, a snack hut that had probably the greasiest, most bad for you things on the planet of like frozen reheated pizza, nachos with the cheap drippy cheese, and everything I loved in my little arteries desired. Bonbons, do y'all remember bonbons? Now they're called dibs. They're these little things of ice cream of heaven dipped in a chocolate shell, and the drippy cheese cheap cheese nachos were that nacho cheese was like, it looked like liquid gold. It was like that Nickelodeon orangey yellow tone. And we would stay out so late till midnight. And sometimes we would just stay in our car and stay and watch two movies instead of just one. You can't do that at a movie theater. They will kick you out. But you could do that at the, unless my dad was just doing crazy things and we were just had all the freedom in the world. But we couldn't do that with my father now. But you just don't see that now. Now we have stuff like Netflix, Hulu, so many things that everyone wants to stay at home and watch. Everything could be streamed on your phone. You could go to meetings on your phone. But honestly, I kind of love it because I'm a homebody, and on the new dual screen LG phone, you could watch your Netflix and you could play games at the same time while you're watching your show. How magical is that? You know those shows that you have that you like have seen so many times, you like hearing it in the background? That's what I'll be doing on my phone, playing on Netflix while I'm playing my games. But things have changed so much lately. Like I feel like toys have gotten so advanced. Like Hatchimals are out now and those are expensive. They're like almost $100 to hatch an electronic egg with some sort of like animal-like creature in it. But we had this thing called Pogs. Pogs were magical. It was such a simple game of these things that literally look like soda can, not like lids from a bottle. And you would just stack them up and try to hit someone's pile of Pogs with another Pog. The Pog was the lid looking thing, and hit it until you like got them out of this ring, and if you hit them over, you get to take the other person's Pogs. Like, Pogs was no joke. We had Pokemon and Pogs, and if you won the other person's cards, you took them. I feel like if that happened now, like, people are way too sensitive. Speaking of sensitive, I feel like if kids watched Home Alone now, their parents would be upset because they probably would think that it was teaching kids that they should be wanting to stay at home. That movie was everything. So in Home Alone, why it was such a good movie is because they also had this device that came from it called Talk Boy. They also came out with a Talk Girl later, which I wanted that by. Yeah, I did have the Talk Girl, I didn't have the Talk Boy. So they were these devices that recorded your voice on a tape recorder. What's a tape, you might ask? Oh my gosh. It was this little plastic, like back when they had VHSs to watch instead of DVDs. It was this little plastic thing that had a physical, like, that had all the recordings on it. And what we had to do to make mixtapes for people that we loved and cherished was we had to listen to the radio. And any top of the popular songs or favorite songs, we had to record it on time and hit the record button while it was playing on the radio to record it for our friends. It was wild. And you only had one shot. just that one chance, none other. You could do CDs later on. So to make a mix CD, you would just drag and drop from your laptop or whatever songs were in the library on your computer and drag it onto the CD to copy it to make a CD. I would do this in college, just everywhere. We had two-way pagers back then, meaning it was like this little device that was almost like a voicemail in your pocket. So it just told you the number of the person that was trying to get a hold of you to paged you. They wanted you to call them. That's what that meant. So we had to go to a payphone or a phone that was attached to a wall to call this person. Yes, instead of cell phones in our pockets, we had to use a quarter, not a credit card, to put into a payphone to call someone. And kids didn't have pagers or cell phones, so we just had to be home by the time the street lights were coming on. Like, oh my gosh, we had this thing called a Pioneer CD player, if you don't know what that is. So, what we played our CDs on were CD players, and we had big ones in the house, and the biggest brand at the time, I think, was Pioneer. And I had one, and I would play CDs from the band NSYNC. I was like the first girl in my grade to have an NSYNC CD. It was like heaven on earth for girls my age growing up. They also had portable CD players, which I was grateful enough to have. And I would walk to 7-Eleven from my house, the convenience store, to get all the snacks during the summer with my CD player, which is so dangerous. Like, that means I'm not paying attention to my surroundings. And then if you like skipped, jump, or ran with the CD player, it would skip the song. While these giant headphones, not earbuds, not any type of little wireless headphones that you put in your ears existed then. It was giant headphones. Or people would even walk around with boom boxes. We also had what's popular now is Furbies are still popular, which is funny because we also had was tech dogs, techno dogs. That was our electronic thing of the past. Like now they even have Nintendogs. We didn't have that. The thing that I was obsessed with when I was a child before YouTube came around, before you watched people on YouTube playing games, before there was really gamers, we played so many games on so many different devices that are so different than the devices that you see today, but they were kind of similar to the gaming pads that you have on this LG dual screen phone. Oh my gosh, there's this gaming controller on the LG dual screen phone that's of this steering wheel, and it so reminds me of when we would go to the arcades to play this one video game that we also had at home on N64 called Hydro Thunder. My entire family was obsessed with it, and it was boat racing, and it was so much fun. There was like hidden secrets in it, and you'd race on all of these canals through different parts of the world and these tracks that were on in the water. It was so much fun, and that's what that reminds me of. And there's also so many screen options on this phone. It just takes me back to like N64 days. That was the Nintendo 64 gaming console that was so archaic, where we had DDR, we had Donkey Kong Country was my absolute favorite, and Kirby's Crystal Castle. I was so obsessed with Kirby's Crystal Castle that was back when Blockbuster was really popular in other movie rental places, and they had expansion packs that you could attach to your controller, and they had an actual DDR Dance Dance Revolution dancing pad like at the arcades that you could bring in your own home if you're rich enough and bougie enough. And we also had Mario Party and Super Mario Smash Bros. That was so great if you had friends over. If you had that game and friends over, you were like the popular kid. Even if you're a nerd, if you had that at a certain time, you're, oh my gosh, and Tony Hawk. Tony Hawk Pro Skater game was so much fun. The one game on Nintendo 64 I was also obsessed with my brother was Pokemon Stadium. Now, my favorite Pokemon Stadium was the weird part where there was this Lickitung character on there who you had like a Lickitung sushi eating contest, and that was my absolute favorite part of the game. But the best game, one of the best games of all time that scared me was Zelda Ocarina of Time and Zelda's Majora's Mask. Majora's Mask was so scary that I would have my brother play the hard parts on that because I was a chicken. and he was my younger brother. And of course I got heckled and made fun of the entire time he was beating the hard parts of the game for me. We also had classic Nintendo before Nintendo 64. Does anyone else remember Lego Mindstorm? Oh my gosh, that's back when Legos were also like robots. That was like, so we thought the future was here when it came to Lego Mindstorm. Back in the day when we could go to arcades, me and my brother would go with our dad, because our dad was kind of like a kid too at heart. He would take us to this arcade called Nickel Nickel, and every game was a nickel. They had this Safari Hunter game that was my favorite. And honestly, a lot of the gaming controllers that are on this phone remind me of some of the old school games that you could play in the arcades. Especially this one reminds me of The Simpsons when you have the joystick. That Simpsons game, we would go to this pizza parlor every weekend almost and try to beat The Simpsons arcade game. That was the most fun game ever. Like honestly, I miss my classic Nintendo. I feel like buying another one. And I swear that back then when we had arcade games, it was so much more fun because I feel like you got more free money if you won tickets, and no one cared about winning tickets as much then as they do now. But that might just be my memory. And on top of that, we just cared about like the game and playing and beating games. But when we did get tickets, you would get so much more money, I feel like, than you get worth for your tickets nowadays. All right, we are going to change up this makeup a little bit because I'm gonna have more of this white, like so, so that the swiping motion's coming this way, yes. Because while researching on my LG phone, you can literally use this dual screen to the best of its capabilities, meaning you could see the entire page on both screens. How amazing is this? So I could look at all the pictures, research all of the images of the 1920s and 1920 films like Nosferatu, Charlie Chaplin, and look at the noir beautiful makeups that we're inspired by to do a black and white version of this today. And you can really look at the blending on the makeups and everything. It is absolutely fantastic. Look at that. You could look at photos to research makeup while you look at YouTube tutorials. So I could watch YouTube while looking at all of the makeup details. How amazing is that? It's just fantastic. So back to what we were talking about on gaming. We had Game Boy Color that came out in 1999. I had this purple Game Boy Color that was like a clear purple. It was so gorgeous. I say gorgeous because the reason why I wanted this purple one, I loved purple. It was like a lavender, crystal clear Game Boy Color. And why I loved it, they had this matching, it looked like a reading lamp, honestly. And it looked like a UFO. That's why I loved it, because I was really into X-Files. I still really am into X-Files. I grew up on X-Files and creepy shows like Tales from the Crypt and Goosebumps. So that was right up my alley. And the little gaming light that came with the Game Boy reminded me of the UFOs from X-Files. That's what sold me. I wanted to be Dana Scully. I almost look like I'm part clown in the best way possible. Now, before there was a Game Boy Color, there was a Tiger handheld games. All the games weren't in cartridges or separate. They're in the device. There were games from Disney like Lion King. There was Ninja Turtles, there was fighting games, there were a lot of sports games. We also had Doom on PC and Sims. I remember I also used to play this game called Zumbinis. Zumbinis was this game that taught you about math and patterns and stuff. They kind of mostly had them in schools. We also had this game called Hugo, which was my favorite. It was so 8-bit and weird, and Tomb Raider. So another great thing I love about this phone is when you're taking your progress photos, you could actually see in real time what your photos are gonna look like after you take them. And another thing that I also wanted to show y'all, which is so cool, is the beauty mode of the light ring light. You could do white, bright, or you could do a more warm or cool tone light,
to see your makeup and take pictures. So you have a ring light built into the phone when you're traveling. You can see what your makeup looks like and really show how well it's all blended.
I know the LG dual screen phone is so crazy cool. The cameras in the past were so archaic, so different. We had this one that I always remembered, which was the Polaroid iZone, I think it was, and they had like stickers so that you could take a picture of this little tiny picture and have it as a sticker that you give to your friends and could stick it on things, which was super cool, but not nowhere near as cool as the LG dual screen, to be honest. Disposable cameras were my fave, are still my fave, because I still use disposable cameras with my friends and we still scrapbook, like we're old grannies. It's great. Not only back then were we as cool as our phones, but our fashion, oh my gosh, girl. We had puka shells, we had choker necklaces, and bell bottoms. I remember when I went to summer camp, it was actually winter camp. It was fifth grade camp, and bell bottoms were all the rage. So much so that, of course, my mother would not buy them for me because they were more money, because they were more fabric to make, and they were so popular that all of the fashion companies were making a lot of bell bottoms and selling them for a lot more money than regular straight leg jeans. So my mother, of course, to save money, bought me straight leg jeans. And I was so heartbroken because I didn't think I'd fit in with all the other girls and friends in my class. And they actually made fun of me because I had straight leg jeans until we went to camp and it was snowing. And all the girls' bell bottoms captured the snow until it soaked their pants up to their legs and thighs. And I was as cool as a cucumber without having soaked pants because I didn't have bell bottoms. And it worked out for me in the end. And I'm glad. We also had butterfly clips in our hair, a lot of them. The more butterfly clips you had in your hair, it was like to show your status on the playground. We also had these cool things called jelly shoes. Like back then we didn't have Yeezys and like whatever shoe is popular today. We had these shoes called jellies. It's just insane to me how much things have changed in makeup and with electronics, because I remember having flip phones and how excited I was then to have this thing that played Snake on my phone and I could text friends, and that was it. We could call, text, and play Snake and Tetris. Like sometimes time goes by so fast and it worries me, but then other times it's like, wow, that's super cool, you know? We also have to change our outfit, duh. Not change, but add a more modern twist to this side of it. So there you have it, a modern girl 2020 beauty makeup Instagram model. She wants to be an actress, maybe. She really loves makeup, loves brunch, super cute. Absolutely love wigs to play with, looks like this. And then on the other side, underneath I should say, we have a 1920s inspired black and white film actress. Beauty makeup of the totally different style of beauty makeup back in the day. So I hope you guys enjoyed these looks of the modern everyday girl in the 1920s version. This was so much fun to do. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much to LG for partnering with me. I absolutely love the dual screen phone. The ring light is amazing, but I love that you could do two things at once. I could go through TikTok and Instagram at the same time. As you can see the difference in that this phone performs from my older phone, it's pretty awesome. So the links will be down below to check this out. What I would like to know down in the comments today is, what was the first cell phone that you guys had? And what would you do if you had this dual screen V60 phone? Leave your thoughts in the comments down below. I would love to hear your ideas. And just like in beauty makeup, it's so crazy how much of a difference everyday beauty makeup is and in the eye of society back in the 1920s from 2020. The difference is insane. Look at this. So thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys. I'll see you in the next video. Subscribe for more videos. I do 2 videos a week every Monday and Friday on this channel. Talk to you then. Bye.